So welcome to day two of the Empty Nesters in Aruba. Pretty much for the first day, we got in so late, room wasn't actually ready. So we went to the casino, played a little bit, explored the resort a little bit. And then later that evening, we went over to Palm Bay Plaza and explored over there. But this is our first beach day, and this is the beach. So later on in the evening, we had our first dinner reservation at the Kyoto, which is the Japanese cuisine restaurant at the Barcelo, offers hibachi, which was actually the best meal we had on the property, or at least my favorite meal on the property. We actually went here twice. Sorry, I have no pics, but I got the salmon and it was the bomb. Welcome to day three. That's the weekly entertainment schedule for the nightly entertainment, actually, at the Barcelo. They always have entertainment in the main bar lobby, as well as some stage shows in the facility. Decided to take a cab down to Aranjestad today, which is the capital city of Aruba. So our driver dropped us off at the Paddock restaurant right here at the cruise terminal, where there's pop-up shops. The colorful Dutch-inspired buildings are down here. Really beautiful, very picturesque. There is high-end shopping down here. Got an opportunity to check out some of the Pharrell pieces in the Louis store. This was actually a great day to come down here because there weren't any cruise ships in town this particular day. If there were, this area would have been packed with tourists, trust me. So right now we're inside the Renaissance Mall, and this mall has everything from Ralph Lauren to Zara. So there's a free trolley service in downtown Aranjestad that'll take you around downtown. There's some tour guides that'll tell you a little bit about the area. This building is the National Archaeological Museum of Aruba. Pretty cool stuff down here. So be sure to check it out on your next visit. So later that evening, we went back over to Palm Beach Plaza. And over there, there's free entertainment over there as well. Count me in for anything free, particularly when it involves pretty dancing girls. So then we returned to the resort to find out it was disco night. Check it out. So it's island tour day here in Aruba, and this is officially our third full day on the island. I highly recommend taking island tours when you visit some of these Caribbean destinations. You get to see so much, particularly if you're not going to rent a car on your own and explore. This is Hirashi Beach, and it is beautiful. So the tour company we chose is De Palm Tours, and that's pretty much because they are located in the Barcelo, which is the first resort we stayed at on our trip. This is the first stop, which is the California Lighthouse. So the lighthouse derives its name from the British steamship, the SS California, which sank nearby in 1891, not the state of California, despite popular belief. But today was a pretty busy day here at the lighthouse. It was a couple of other tour buses that were here visiting. It's probably safe to assume that there were a couple of cruise ships docked in Aruba on this particular day. But there's a lot to see and do here. There is a sit-down restaurant, and the views are just phenomenal. This is the side of the restaurant right here, and you can see that water is just gorgeous. Oh, my God. So our next stop on the tour today is a visit to the butterfly farm of Aruba. And this is the second butterfly farm that these folks have. The original butterfly farm was founded in 1994 on the French side of St. Martin. However, due to the hurricane that hit in 2017, Hurricane Irma, that facility remains to be closed to this day. But at any rate, if you're going to visit Aruba, please check out the butterfly farm. It is a must.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to the farm. My name is Shalene once again. I'll be your guide today. So what I'll do is just give you a very small explanation of the farm, tell you a little bit about the different types of butterflies we have in our garden. So if you have any questions later, it's completely up to you how you poke and prod my brain on that one. But in the meantime, let's just jump into it. Whenever fruit ferments, it basically turns into alcohol. So what it's doing is getting drunk. As you can see, it doesn't care that I'm near it, so it's, I'm pretty sure it's pretty tapped out already. So personally, I would say this is where the magic is happening right now. So basically, for a caterpillar to turn into one of these chrysalis, it's first gonna hide, it's gonna pick a nice spot where it feels safe.
So next up on the tour is a trip to the Royal Aruba Aloe Company factory. And if you are familiar with aloe, ever used aloe, love aloe, you will definitely get a kick out of this.
Yeah. Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, you guys are going to start off by saying good afternoon, everyone. How's everybody doing today? Everybody doing good?
Yes.
Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Aruba Aloe factory. My name is Tarek. For this next about 20 minutes or so, you guys are all kind of stuck with me today, all right? Sounds good? All right, so let's start right away with the first part that we have then, the beautiful field, all right? If you guys take a look at this field that we have, we actually built this field way back in 1890. I'd say the field as well as the company is already getting close to being 134 years old, which means that right now we are the oldest aloe working company to ever exist. All right? Now, we initially started working with it. You can see this was the field that we used to own. Do you have anyone here that's ever seen a yellow sap before? Maybe heard of it, by any chance?
Heard of it?
Most of you guys never heard of it, never seen it?
No.
Well, then I guess the easiest way that I can explain it, do we have anyone that's constipated today? And when it comes to constipation on Aruba, this is how we get rid of it, and it's very easy as well. The first thing you need to do is always make sure you have a decent sized aloe vera plant, and that we're just gonna cut one of the leaves that it has. Okay, so we're gonna cut this one over here. Okay, so we just cut it at the bottom. We go right over here. You see, this is the yellow sap that I'm talking about right now, right? There we go. Everybody see the yellow sap? Okay, now does everybody here knows what a laxative is? Everybody knows what a laxative does to you, right? That yellow sap over there, so strong of a natural laxative. Drink around 4 or 5 drops of it. Enjoy the rest of your tour. So now would anyone like a small sample of it to see if it actually worked?
No.
So we're going to start from the cutting part of it all the way to the labeling and the packaging. But just so you guys know, the cutting, you're not going to see it happening live today, all right? The cutting that we have, it only happens twice a week. They have some specialized tools, but the process goes as follows. That is the first step that we have, which is the washing. Okay, so we always start off by washing it for about 10 to 15 minutes because you always want to get rid of most of the yellow sap. And eventually, once the yellow sap starts oxidizing,
so one of the things that I found interesting about the Royal Aruba Factory Company is that it is privately owned. And versus automating to machinery for a lot of the functionality here, they have chosen to hire local Arubians to support the local economy with jobs. Kudos. So here we are back on our nice air-conditioned bus. What I'll say about the palm tours is they actually give you two options. You can choose to tour on the comfy air-conditioned bus, or you can do the SUV route. They offer a Jeep ride, which is very bumpy and no air conditioning. But here we are at the Natural Bridge Ruins, which is our next stop. So now we're in Arakok National Park, and this right here is a natural bridge, but this is the baby natural bridge, the original natural bridge, which was way bigger, collapsed in September of 2005. But the ruins are still here, and this is a enter at your own risk kind of tour at this point. As you can see, it's very rocky terrain, but it is simply beautiful. There are even four-wheelers that you can rent to explore on your own. And of course, there's a restaurant and a gift shop on property. Actually, this is where we tried the local dish, the pistachi.
Hey, what's happening?
So we finally reached the last stop on our tour, which is the Kasabari rock formations. Kasabari is an Indian name of Arawak origin, and this is a prehistoric site. There are still evidence of prehistoric rock drawings on some of these rocks. However, we did not find them, But as you can see, this was one heck of a climb, and I'm really impressed with my wife. Again, at this point, I thought she was going to turn around and say, nah, let's go back. But she trekked on. This is definitely a sight worth seeing, and I would definitely recommend a good pair of sneakers or shoes with good grip. Obviously, mountain climbing shoes would be excellent, but who's going to bring that to Aruba? But at any rate, this view is spectacular, and as you'll see, you can see the entire island from up here. You see that mountain back there that looks like a volcano? That was Huiberg. Aruba is a volcanic island which was probably formed millions of years ago when volcanoes erupted on the floor of the ocean. And now the trek back down to the bottom. So later that evening, we had reservations at Leolo, which is the Italian restaurant on the property of the Barcello. Wifey tried the lamb chops. I had salmon myself. And this is the view of the balcony overlooking the pool at the Barcello. And it was a gorgeous night, I'll tell you that. The meal was excellent, probably my second favorite restaurant on property. Now it's time for a nightcap at the buffet. And that's the dessert buffet. So today, folks, is a lazy pool day. Nothing on the agenda today but to linger here poolside at the Barcello. Now, if you're planning a stay at the Barcello and you're looking to linger a little bit poolside, I will say you'll have to get up early to reserve a chair. These folks don't play. And because I get up early to get coffee or even to shoot content, today I was able to reserve us a spot poolside. Now the folks that come here frequently love the Barcello. As you can see, someone's auntie just having too much fun. But the staff here is excellent. The resort is a little dated, but it isn't all inclusive. It is a timeshare. Barcello owners love this place. I mean, they come here multiple times a year. There's a Facebook group called I Love Barcello. Check it out if you're thinking about coming here for a stay. So tonight's show at the resort is Carnival, and it was all about the Aruban version of Carnival. We had an opportunity to check out Carnival firsthand in St. Martin last year. I wouldn't mind coming back to Aruba to check theirs out. I might just have to add that to my to-do list. So the next day, we decided to do absolutely nothing again. And this time, we're at the beach. So it's a lazy beach day. And sometimes on vacation, you just need to spend days where you do absolutely nothing. Just sit back and enjoy the views. So those of you that know my queen know she's a fan of the casino. And so later on this evening, we decided to go next door to the Hilton to check out their casino. So this is Palm Beach Plaza, which is across the street from the Barcelo and the Hilton. We'll follow back with the Hilton later on because we'll be moving over there for the second half of our stay. But this is our walk back over to the Barcelo. So on our walk back, we noticed that the gelato spot did not have a line. I mean, all week long, we saw long lines waiting to get this ice cream. But when we saw our opportunity, we pounced, and it was well worth it. It was very good. We even went back on another night. So today is our last day at the Barcelo. And of course, no better way to spend it than at the beach. So this isn't our last day on the Happy Island. Tomorrow, we actually check into the Hilton, which is actually next door, and really is night and day from the Barcelo. They are two really completely different resorts to be so close to one another. But more on that to come. Stay tuned. So after spending the entire day at the beach, it was time for a sunset dinner. But first, let me take you guys through the lobby of the Barcelo, which is a grand lobby. It's the casino over there, the main bar, the stage. And now back to that sunset dinner. We actually scored a walk-up reservation at L'Olio. This is the Italian restaurant on the property, which hands down was our favorite, and we actually scored patio at sunset. It was beautiful. So it's the following morning and we're checking in next door at the Hilton, which as you can see is a completely different resort styling wise. Both of these resorts are about the same age. I want to say they were built in the 50s or 60s even. This resort is actually under a refurbishment, but kudos to Hilton because they're doing an excellent job down there of hiding the fact that this resort is being refurbished. So follow along now. Of course, we're going to head to the beach while we wait for our room to get ready. So now that we're fully checked into the room, we decided to head to the pool. And as you can see, compared to what I've showed you in previous videos or earlier of the Barcelo, I mean, it's a completely different vibe over here. Even though there's still plenty of activities, it's just a little bit more chill and relaxed over here, and we were good with that. I mean, it's Saturday, and there is plenty of room, as you can see, at the pool. The same thing at the beach. There were plenty of palapas, and I appreciate the fact that I didn't have to get up early to secure a palapa or a spot at the pool. Part of that's due to our Hilton honor status, but hey, I'll come back here in a heartbeat. So it's a Saturday evening in Aruba, and we decided to head across the street over to Palm Beach Plaza. This is where the action is. Now, if you're coming down here looking for a Miami vibe or a Vegas party vibe, They party down here, but they don't party quite like that. So if you're looking for something a little bit more chill, come to Aruba. So here we are again, back at the bus. Man, I tell you, that was some good ice cream. So we ended our night at the Ryu Casino next door, seeking a jackpot. So today is Mother's Day, and I had to take my beautiful wife to a special Mother's Day dinner at Gianni's. So they're known for serving spaghetti out of these Parmesan cheese bowls. But it was definitely a vibe. For the ambiance alone, this spot is worth checking out if you're visiting Aruba. So it's the following day, and it is time for us to say goodbye to the happy island of Aruba. And we are en route to the airport, driving through the capital city of Aranjestad.